Made a crazy decision.
Love this one.
I feel awful.
Did you feel like you're gonna vom the whole time?
What's up, bitch?
So I just did a live. It was very fun. It's my first live ever. I'm gonna make sure I post a story as well. I need some mama's help. I'm building a resource right now for mamas. It's a very new process and I want to do it right. So I'm not gonna just blindly build something that no one gives an F about. So I need to ask for your help. What is your biggest struggle relating to motherhood? What makes you feel the most powerful as a mother? Like, is there practice, a routine, something that if you were to miss it, it would make you feel completely behind? Like for me, for example, I like to have a really self-centered morning routine. I gotta have my journal, I gotta have my book, I gotta have my planner and my Bible, and I want that to myself. Like, I don't wanna wake up with expectations the second I wake up, because, you know, the second I open my eyes, if my child and my husband are awake, they're gonna be asking me for shit. It's just inevitable. And so I want a self-centered morning routine so that I can feel really set up for my day. Another example of this might be doing the dishes before you go to bed. For some people, that's a huge trigger, and then you feel like you're just behind the whole rest of the day. That's an example of something that might make you feel really powerful. So on the flip side of that, I also want to know what drains you of your power. So like leaving a sink full of dishes, or oversleeping, or scrolling through Instagram and seeing a perfect $1 million home with this perfect mom and her daughter's matching outfits. And you're like, shit, I could never do that. I could never be that mom. So what's the point? So I know a lot of struggle with mindsets like that and perfectionism, and these are all things I want to include in this resource. I'm so excited, but I really need your help, and I really want you guys to be a part of. So yeah, I really need and want you guys to be a part of building this, because it's really for you, and so I want it. Let me just rest through this some more. I'm excited, you guys. I need you to be a part of this. I do. Otherwise, it's not gonna be important, because, I mean, I can make important things, but if it's not based off of what you need, am I really serving anybody? No. So, send me a DM.
Grandma made something for you.
Yeah.
It's even more special.
You said you wanted a dress.
Oh, wow.
So I made you a dress.
Thanks, Grandma.
What show is that from? I bet you could sleep like a cloud baby tonight.
Rose, it's just perfect. So who are you?
They are cloud babies.
Oh, they're just cloud babies.
Good morning. I'm making French toast. It's not healthy, but the baby needs French toast, and so if the baby needs French toast, then the baby gets French toast.
Okay.
Some of the best recipes I've made, or based some of my favorite recipes off of, are just things I Google, and they turn out great. So you gotta just try new things. This is the recipe I'm using.
Oh, I just bought a Dakota tot. So fun. You just wanna Google fluffy French toast, and it is the first result right here. Different because it uses flour, but I'm such a fan.
Is it good?
Good.
Is it yummy?
Yeah.
Guys, I'm gonna do it. I'm getting an iPhone.
top of the morning to ya. I am very excited because something I've been waiting for just got here. Made a crazy decision to go iPhone. I've been an avid Android fan for a long time, but I saw the videos that could be created with the iPhone 12 Pro Max. They were actually sent me the 12 Pro by accident, so I've been patiently or impatiently waiting to get the correct phone. It's here, I'm so excited. I'm making us BLTs at the moment.
Here's the outfit of the day.
Moment we've all been waiting for. The unboxing. Dun dun dun. Look how nice. Look at those cameras. Now you'll see Zach and I sporting some matching Apple Watches. I'm gonna set this up and then eat a BLT. I'll be right back. Good morning. It's the next day. Got lots on the agenda today. Little nesting happening here. I've got a doctor's appointment, a baby doctor at 2:45. It's about 10 a.m. June 30th. It's a Wednesday. And a humid Wednesday it is. So if you see me glowing, it's not because my skin's just that dewy. It's because it's humid AF in here. But I'm about to go make some fried potatoes and eggs. Hope you're ready. Because I'm not. I can barely breathe. It's okay though. It'll be fine. It'll be okay. Got a lot of laundry to do. I'll show you guys upstairs some of the cute baby clothes that I got. This is everything I added. I really like these. They're changing pad covers. Got them off Amazon. I'll link them below if you wanna snag some. I have a feeling this is gonna be hard to take off. So here's some of the things I got our little baby. Of course, I got like all zippers because if you're a second time mom, you learn. That's all you're gonna wanna use.
For real, for real.
My friend Kaylee picked up a few things too. This is one of the things she got when she came shopping with us. The dinos. These ones came in a pack as well. I think this one might be my favorite. Look how cute. This one and that one. Little dinos. They've got a cute little hood on the back. Showed you guys these already from TJ Maxx. This will be me. Is it nap time yet? Love this one. And Kaylee got this one too with the little crabbies. And those are all from Target, so if you're having a little boy. And then I went through all of Rosalie's clothes and I found the ones that can be gender neutral, which was not very many because I dressed her very girly. I gotta hurry up, throw this stuff in, and get ready for my doctor's appointment, like now. I'm hoping so. It's not bad.
Good morning. 7 a.m. on a Saturday. and I get to redo my glucose testing because my numbers were just a little bit higher than they like. So I get to do the, I think it's 3 hours, might be here for four, I'm not sure. Three different blood draws, and I haven't eaten, so it'll be fun, really fun. I'm already hungry. Round two. Round one done. People can't eat anything, drink anything. And I'm 30 weeks pregnant today, by the way.
I feel awful.
Mom is hungry.
Okay, I'm home now. This morning was like the longest morning of my life. So it was actually four blood draws in 3 hours. So I had one at 7:30, 8:30, 9:30, and then 10:30. And then got my nails done. So that was so long. I hate when it takes absurdly long to get your nails done. Like, I want to get in there and get done. It was like 2.5 hours for a mani-pedi. I mean, I'm not, I shouldn't be complaining about that, but I am. I know, it's a problem, isn't it, Zach? And then after that, I had to go to Costco. And now it's like 4:30, and I woke up at 5:30, so like, I'm ready for bed. What did you guys think of the glucose test? Did you have to do the fasted one? And if so, did you feel like you're gonna vom the whole time? Because I did, and I did not expect it to affect me like that. The lady, bless her heart, saw me struggling out there in the waiting room. I was like fanning myself. She was like, I think she told one of the other ladies, I think we're about to lose our glucose. I'm like, yeah, I almost lost it. So the non-fasted test was fine. I didn't have any issues at all, but fasted test, I was just nauseous the whole time and I had to be there for 3 hours. So thankfully they let me go in the back room where they had a reclining seat, and I actually fell asleep for like probably 20 minutes because they shut the lights off for me. I had my headphones in. Got much better. After that, I think it was the second blood draw. After that one, that's when I went back to that room, and after that, it was so much better. So let me know how that went for you guys, because I struggled. I'm gonna end this vlog here. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new. Love and light to you all. Make sure to stay groovy. Bye.